Los hijos de la escritora Heather Ramack ya son adultos. Cuando ella y su esposo adoptaron a Chuckles en su familia, el can se convirtió en otro hijo para ellos, un hijo, digamos, cleptómano.
When we have house guests, especially when he was a puppy, I had to caution them not to leave their suitcases on the floor of their bedroom because he would go in and take items from their suitcase and bring them downstairs and put them in his toy box. Once they were in his toy box, as far as he was concerned, those items were his. And people would come down, I thought I brought a pair of wool socks with me. And we'd say, eh, check the toy box, and there they would be. So, you want to go first? That's a boy.
Heather y Chuckles son prácticamente inseparables. Caminan varios kilómetros juntos todos los días. Pero su rutina familiar diaria fue interrumpida cuando a Heather se le diagnosticó cáncer avanzado en los ovarios.
I'm thinking, well, you know, my kids understand the odds against my survival. I'm going through, you know, how I'll explain to my husband. And then I got down to Chuckles, who was just a year old, and I thought, how can you explain to a dog that you're going to die? He'll think I've abandoned him. He'll think I don't love him if I don't come home. Certainly, I did count on my family members. Believe me, I mean, I needed to see those grandchildren grow up. I needed to see my daughter married. You know, I wanted to be part of everyone's lives into the future.
Yes, you are.
But there was this sense of not wanting to abandon the dog.
Heather estuvo 2 semanas en el hospital. Su esposo Gene se hizo cargo de Chuckles mientras ella no estaba, pero ninguno podía predecir el comportamiento de su perro cuando ella regresó a casa.
My daughter-in-law had made up a bed for me on the couch because I wasn't allowed to go up and down the stairs. I lay down to take a nap. And while I was sleeping, I had no awareness of it. Didn't know that he was doing anything, but when I woke up, Chuckles had emptied out his toy box, and what he'd done, he had tucked all his toys in around me while I slept. So I had the little yellow ducky, I think, was under my chin. I had the rabbit stuff behind my head, a frisbee on my stomach, a stuffed squirrel somewhere else, tennis balls everywhere. I woke up, and what is all this stuff? And he had just covered me, and you know, I laughed about it. I wasn't sure what it meant, but in the end, I decided that he was just giving me everything he had. You know, he was giving me his all.
Here, Chuckles, wait for Mom. We'll sit there.
Esa misma tarde y todos los días desde entonces, Heather ha llevado a Chuckles de paseo, ya que no quiere desilusionar a su amoroso perro.
Here, Chuckles.
Ella superó el cáncer hace 8 años y considera que Chuckles ayudó a salvarle la vida.
I was forced to face my own mortality, and if I had a day when I was a little weepy, I had a good dog just sitting there taking care of those tears. A dog lives in the moment so much. A dog can teach you to be in the here and now. Just, hey, this moment is perfect. What more do you need? Look at that tree. Look at those rabbit tracks.